Ed, welcome to Elizabeth's Craft Room. Let's just see if the technology is working here today. And I am in. Let's just see. These business pages have got so much on them. Yes, that's looking good. That looks like what I'm wearing today. And Vanessa is with me live this afternoon. Hello, lovely Vanessa. How's the weather where you are? It is so gloomy here today. It's gloomy and rainy and windy, and it's much nicer to be sitting indoors in my craft room than doing anything else. So tell me how it is where you are today. I can see another few people are joining us. Hi, lovely to have you with us. So I am planning a little break. Not going anywhere because we are completely locked down in the UK again. Here we go again for at least another couple of weeks. Hopefully it will ease up after that. But so we are staying indoors safe. So we're not really going anywhere, but I am going to have a short break, which will be lovely. Vanessa said it's sunny here. Oh, enjoy the sunshine. It's supposed to be sunny tomorrow, so I'm hoping to go out for a walk tomorrow in the sunshine. Right, I can see a few more are joining in. So yes, I'm going to take a few days off. Yay! This will be my first week off I'm going to have since last November. I have been working 6 days a week on my Stampin' Up! Business and looking after my lovely ladies through this very, very weird year. So I am really ready for a break. My mum has been poorly. She had a stroke earlier in the year. She's been poorly. And she's in a beautiful, beautiful care home. She needs 24-hour care now. But they've had COVID in there, so that's been awful, but it's all clear. So all happy here, very, very happy. Happy mum, happy us, and yeah, happy to be taking just a few days off. But before I go, I'm going to hang out with you guys. We've got Diane from Australia. Hi, Diane, up very late, 1 o'clock in the morning. Nice to have you with us. I can see that there are more, but it's not updating with names on my system, and I'm not really quite sure why. Yeah. Thank you very much, Vanessa, saying it's well-deserved time off. Yeah, definitely need it. Definitely need it. A lot of work and a hard old year. And goodness me, I know I'm not the only one. So many of us. But yes, I'm going to chill out. I'm going to read a book. I'm going to play my yong with my lovely husband. And we're going to just have a very relaxing time. So really, really looking forward to this. Hi Pam. Pam is with us as well. Hi Pam, and Kathy is joining us too. Hi Kathy, lovely to have you with us this afternoon. So yes, although I am leaving you for a week, I'm kind of leaving you, not leaving you, because next Wednesday I have a video planned for you. It is a remake of my most popular video ever, which is my craft room tour. But since I did it, which is about 6 years ago, I've had a few changes round. I've got things in different places. Oh, lovely Liz Yule's joining us. Hi, Liz. And so, yeah, I've kind of moved things around. So I thought I would do a new craft room tour for you next Wednesday. So although I'm going to take some time off, I'll be back again. You'll see my face and you'll see the craft room, and you can have a little nose around and see where I work and what it all looks like when it's neat. Doesn't always look like it does on the video. So I just saw Liz Yule has posted a show that she was doing from last year. And it suddenly, you look at that and you see pictures of us out and about and people without masks, and it's another world. Who would have predicted this very, very weird year? But so much good news this week about vaccines and things, and maybe we'll all be together again. And, you know, Won't that be wonderful to be out in the real world again? But then I do get the chance at the moment to talk to all of you, to talk to Kathy, who is on the other side of the Atlantic and has just woken up, to talk to Diane, who's staying up late in Australia, to speak to Vanessa in Germany, so, and Liz in the UK. So it's really nice to at least kind of get to spend a little bit of online time together. Kathy says she likes craft room tours. So do I. I've always loved craft room tours. And in fact, the story, which I haven't put in the other video, so I can tell you now, but the story of my dream craft room, which this absolutely is that I used to work on a desk that was about 5 foot long, in the same place in front of my window here, but this room was also an office because I worked from home for British Telecom for 18 years. So I worked in here and then I had a little desk where I did my crafting. And then all the time that I was a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator until I went full time, which was about 5.5 years, I saved everything that I made from my Stampin' Up! Business in an account. I didn't spend it on anything. All the Stampin' Up! Goodies that we buy as demonstrators, I bought out of my wages, and I put my profits from my Stampin' Up! Business away for, well, by the time we got there, almost 6 years. And then in my head, I had something like this craft room. And one of my team is a kitchen designer, Carolyn, and her company's called Zentrum Kitchens in the UK. And she came and designed my dream craft room. I went full time. I decided to go full time. I think we're all Stampin' Up! Who are on here at the moment. So some of you know what Heart of Stampin' Up! Is. But I got Heart of Stampin' Up! On stage. My job was going kaput. They were going to have me back in the office. It would have destroyed my Stampin' Up! Business because they wanted me on rotating shifts. So long story short, I went full time. And so then I decided to have my dream craft room, and this is it. And all the savings that I'd done building up my business over those kind of 6 years paid for it. So yeah, my lovely friend Carolyn designed and built this craft room for me, and I will show it all to you next week. But for today, I am going to do a little bit of crafting for you, just one little project today, and a couple of little examples to show you as well. Oh, we've got Ruby joining us as well. Diane says she's looking at the colour signs above the ink pads. Yes, so I've got ink pads here. You see, I'm giving you a sneak peek now, Diane. I've got cardstock in these. That's my scraps are up the top there. So it does look pretty though, doesn't it, to have things on display. But you have to be careful, as I'm sure you all know, where you put the cardstock because it will fade. But I've got a north-facing room, so I'm pretty safe with my cardstock kind of tucked around the corners in my room. So talking of which, let's move you across to my craft desk and I will show you a little project idea that I have. So as usual, the non-technical way of me moving you is to move the phone. And here we go. Let's get you lined up. And turn my iPad around so I can see any comments. So the thing I'm going to use today is the In Good Taste Designer Series paper. Now, this is on page 122-23 of the catalogue, and it's this beautiful paper here. I found this so versatile that I've gone through two whole packs, and that's without much of it going into classes. That's me demonstrating with it and things, but making projects with it. But it really is so versatile. It is a big, giant set. So when you see it, you think, oh, my goodness, that's twice the price. But actually, it's a bargain because you get double the amount. And I've still gone through two packs of it because it is so useful. It does coordinate with this stamp set here, which is Tasteful Touches, which we have used in classes this year. But it actually goes with pretty much anything, and it is fantastic for man cards as well. So I thought I would show you a card that could be a birthday card or could be an anniversary card. So something a little bit different rather than Christmas again, because I think I don't know about you, but I'm feeling Christmased out at the moment. I'm ready for something different. So we're doing a little bit of something different. Oh, Jill is watching us. Hi, Jill. And we've also got Teresa. Hi, Teresa. Teresa's over in the States. So nice to have you with us. So let's pop that out of the way. And so we are going to do a little bit of doodling. Now, I have been doodling on my on some projects recently, one in particular that we are going to do in our in classes coming up, but I just wanted to show some ideas of some doodling, but also I wanted to show a little technique called faux stitching. Now, we have dies now that should do stitching around all sorts of different shapes, and that is fantastic, but sometimes you want a stitched look on something else, and here I'm doing it on a piece of the designer series paper. This is, it looks like fabric, so it is quite nice to do a stitching technique on something that looks like fabric. Now, I'm going to just mark, use my little ruler here to decide where I'm going to do my faux stitches. So I'm going to start up here. Now, it doesn't matter what the measurements are exactly. Mine ruler here, I've happened to have it the centimetre way round, so I'm going every centimetre, but as long as they're fairly evenly spaced, and make little holes. I'm using my pricking tool, I should have said, I'm using the pricking tool on the pick it up, on the take your pick, I couldn't remember what it's called, and a little pricking mat here. And then I'm going to use a marker, I'm using here the Early Espresso, and I'm going to draw stitches in between those holes. Now, of course, if you want to, you can get your needle and thread out and actually sew and actually put some sewing in. But my sewing skills leave a lot to be desired. So it's a lot easier just to draw in my stitches. Now, I've done my little curly bits of thread top and bottom as well. And if you want to make those little poked holes really pop, you can go back in with the marker. It's a bit heavy on that top one. You can go back in with the marker and actually go around those little, whoops, pricked holes. That one was a bit too much as well. But you can see that now looks a little bit stronger and catches your eye a little bit more. But it does look quite stitchy. I think that is my technical term of the day. Oh, lovely Lee is with us as well. Lee's in my team. Hi, Lee. Lee is an amazing person. Lee works for the NHS at our local hospital. She is retiring soon and living a life of wonder and stamping up. But she's a lovely person. So say hey to Lee. Right, okay, so I'm going to layer this up, this piece here. It doesn't really matter the measurements, but I will tell you as I'm here, that was 2 inches by 5, so that's going to be 2 1/4 by 5 1/4. And I'm going to use my Stampin' Seal just for speed and layer that up. Okay, there we go. So that's our first piece. Now, I don't think that's enough doodling and faux stitching. So my next faux stitching doodles I'm going to do are going to be on this piece here. So I'm going to, oh, that's the thick end. We don't want the thick end, not unless we're going to have very heavy duty stitches. So I'm just going to start down here. And this time I'm going to draw a range of different stitches. I'm going to put some dots in there. I'm going to do some sideways ones and some cross stitches. So just a little bit. Lee says, yay, retirement. I'm going to just do a little bit of kind of stitched effect on there. Now I'm going to pop this up on the top here. And before I do that, and when I demoed this morning on my Liz's Lovely Ladies private group where my class customers are, I forgot to do this bit. I had to do it in a different way. But you can always fix everything, can't you, with Stampin' Up? This is the linen thread. And it has been, it's one of those things that has been in the catalogue ever since I've been with Stampin' Up. So, which is coming up on 12 years. And I hope it never goes away. Because it just gives a little bit of something. And again, because we're doing this sort of stitched look, that's good. So I'll just put some more seal on there. And we'll pop that up. Okay, so that's our next layer on this one. Then I'm going to go back to that paper again, and I'm going to use some punches. So I've got some darker ones, and literally this is pretty much all I've got left. I've used so much of this. I'm going to use the Heart Punch Duo and go for a couple of dark layers. With the scalloped one, and then with the light one, I'll go for the regular one. Let's have the wood grain in a different direction. Now again, you could use one of the other fabric samples that are in this, because there are a few that look fabric-y on here. But I do like the fact these are so light for a start, so they show up nicely. But once again, I am going to do some faux stitching. And there is no right or wrong in doing this. Let's just go around here. And again, I would not be able to do this with real stitching, but it does look quite nice. And really, you can, as I say, if you are a good seamstress, you could do this easily. But for me, this is a good way of having a kind of a little stitched look. Go. And Gail is joining us. Hello, lovely Gail. Nice to have you with us. And so I'm just going to layer these up. As I say, really simple card, but just by adding that little bit of doodling, it just gives you something a little bit different. And I also think, you know, it's quite hard sometimes to do a card for a man that you love. But you don't necessarily want it to be hearts and flowers and pink hearts and things. But this would make, I mean, this could be a Valentine's, it could be an anniversary card. And it could be my husband's birthday card. Because people, believe it or not, do have birthdays in December. Shocking and very, very unorganised of him, I thought. But so I'm always looking for a birthday card at this time of year. So I'm going to stamp a little happy birthday again on another scrap of this paper. These images come from Monogram Messages. Now, I used this a few weeks ago when we did the repeat card. If you haven't seen that, that is on my YouTube channel, or if you scroll down a bit, I think it was 2 or 3 weeks ago we did the repeat card, but we used Monogram Messages for that. But I do think these words on here, really useful words and really nice, crisp sort of text on them. And all I'm going to do, rather than punch these, is just literally chop them out. There's the happy. That's the birthday one. I actually quite like that that's almost positioned itself there with those bits. I don't know whether to leave those on. Let's have a look and see. Or whether to chop them off. I think I might chop one of them off. Oh, I don't know. Now you see, now I'm thinking I need to chop them both. Oh, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to use it as an opportunity. Right, okay. It's all come to me, what I'm going to do with these. Okay, so let's pop this on up here. Okay, and let's get some dimensionals, I think, for this one. I haven't used these punches enough. But I must start using them because they're really rather good, and they're quite a good size. Where are we going to have that? I kind of feel I want to get it partly underneath, or maybe all underneath those. Yeah, I quite like that. And then let's have our happy birthday. Now I want to pop these up, so you can use the edges, of course, of your dimensionals. Never waste the edges. I'm going to chop that bit off because it's got attached. So I don't know if you can hear, somebody outside has decided this is a good time to use some sort of a electric drill or power saw or something in the garden, goodness knows how, because it is absolutely pouring it down with rain here in Southampton, England. Now, I just wanted to show you something you may not know. These are the foam adhesive strips, and so they kind of do the same thing as the edges of our dimensionals. But they're much longer, so they're brilliant for if you're doing a shaker card. You can mould them, so you can make them bend round corners. So they're actually really quite good for that. But the other thing that's different between the two is the depth. And this is a little bit thicker. I don't know whether you can see on the camera how well you can see that. But this is quite thick, quite a bit thicker than this one here. So I'm going to pop my birthday up just a little bit taller. Lee is asking, is it Mike that's using the electric saw? No, it isn't. He's annoying me in a whole different way. He's in the other room talking to his songwriting partner on the phone. I can hear them quite easily, but they're probably not quite as loud as the saw. And oh, there we go. And I'm going to pop that. So I'm going to make that even taller than the happy. And then to make it look like that was all planned, look, I'm going to use one of my gilded gems, which I love, and pop that on there. Now, my warning with this card, and let's get a soft suede layer for that to go on top of. My warning with this card is that if you are posting this card in the UK, I have just turned this into a large letter. This is going to cost more to post, because as soon as you go above one layer of dimensionals, and that does include the thickness of the foam adhesive strips, but as soon as you go above that, which I've done with the bling, then you're going to, it's going to be a large letter, so it's going to be more expensive to post. But as I don't need to post this because Michael is in the same house, we're just fine. So that is our project today. Let me show you the other versions of this, which are fairly similar. So this morning when I forgot to wrap the wrap the linen thread around, I did it around the whole of the white bit, but I quite like that. That works out okay, you know, happy accidents and all that. I'm going to take you back and show you a couple more little examples of some kind of faux stitching and a little sneak peek as well. Oh, Vanessa says beautiful. Thank you very much, Vanessa. Let me move you across again. Won't be a moment. Here we go. Right, so I've got another couple of cards that I have been doodling on. One sort of similar with that kind of stitched look, and we've got a little bit of a sneak peek here. So I don't know how much you've been on the internet, but you may have seen something coming soon to a Stampin' Up! Catalogue near you. We have a lovely new dragonfly stamp set with punch. Always love a stamp set that has a punch with it. So I've been having a little play with this. And if you can see around the edge, I have done some doodling very similar to the sort of the stitched bits. I don't think I've got crosses on this one. I think I've just got like sideways stitches and slightly longer lines rather than the faux stitched. Just to show you, this has got the put vellum with this, so you've got vellum backing onto it. So yeah, I love this a lot. And another version of exactly the same card, but another version of the doodling. So here I have just sort of squiggled a little line around. Now, personally, I find this one harder because you don't really want to stop and start. With the others, you can stop and start wherever you need to. Here, when you're trying to go round a corner, it's kind of hard. And if you stop and get a little blot, you end up having to put another loop in to cover it up, like here. So there, again, there is always a way. You can find a way. But yeah, so what kind of doodling do you like? Do you do squiddly doodles on your cards to do a border like this one, or as part of the card design that we looked at today? Do you do faux stitching? I would love to see if you already do this or if you have a go at it. Tell me in the comments below whether you like these, and I look forward to hearing from you. If you want to, you can also subscribe to the YouTube channel. So if you're watching on Catch Up, you will see, I think you can press a little bell. You see, I'm not very techy, but you can press a little bell so you don't miss me. I will be back in a fortnight with another actual live, but 1 week's time I will be back with a craft room tour, so you can have a little peek around my craft room and see where I do my designing and cutting and writing of instructions for classes and all the rest of it. Thank you for visiting Elizabeth's Craft Room today. It's been lovely to see you, those of you who've joined me live, and those that watch and catch up. Thank you for coming too. Bye.